Food. I love food. It's like an addiction, but also we need food to survive. We don't need marijuana to survive, and we don't need beer to survive. Come to think of it, we don't need tea to survive, and we don't need cigarettes to survive. Are you a cigarette addict? Are you a tea addict? You know, it's funny, tea seems so harmless. I can't handle caffeine. Caffeine makes me sick and I get jittery. If I don't drink it, I need more and more and more, and I had to quit altogether. I was with a friend of mine who's an imam, and we were drinking tea, and he had like his fourth glass of tea, and I said, you know, you talk about, you know, having control over your body and your body being a temple, but that's a lot of caffeine. He says, caffeine? I'm just drinking this tea for the flavor. I said, no, you're not. You're drinking this tea because it's loaded with caffeine and you're getting a buzz. He says, I don't understand what you're talking about. So I said, let's go down to the store. So the imam and I went down to the store and I bought him his same Lipton tea, but with no caffeine. He took one sip and he said, I feel that this tea is deceiving me. I said, that's the first honest cup of tea you've ever had in your life. And we both laughed. He's not an addict. But it's important to understand that some things that we consume are more than what they appear. Caffeine drinks, tea, cigarettes. Now, cigarettes, I think they're horrible. They ruin you over time. And again, you're getting a drug. You're giving yourself this drug, which is nicotine. With tea and coffee, you're giving yourself, and soft drinks, you're giving yourself this drug, which is caffeine. Then there's marijuana. Now, see, tea and caffeine, you can drink them your whole life, and no one's ever really going to give you a hard and no one's ever really going to give you a hard time because they're socially acceptable. In America, it's socially acceptable to drink alcohol all the time, except when it starts interfering with your work. So alcohol is definitely dangerous because we can tell by all the people that die. Very few people are murdered because of cigarettes and tea. Like, I'm talking to a young friend of mine. I'm telling him he should get off marijuana. And he says it doesn't hurt at all. It's a great relaxation. If you want to pray, that's wonderful. If you want to do yoga and meditate, that's wonderful. But I think that alcohol and marijuana are cheap, low-budget, cut-rate versions of prayer and meditation. You get this wonderful feeling of euphoria, but you're getting it the cheap and easy way. And you have to pay a price. It may cost you your life. The alcohol can ruin your liver. With marijuana, it makes you a loser. Over time, now, I think, you know, some people can do fine with marijuana, but people who smoke a lot of marijuana end up losing opportunities. Let's say a guy I know smoked marijuana for years. The quality woman he wants to have in his life will never be with him. Because she meets him, and instead of meeting this guy, hi, my name's Joe. Hey, my name's Joe. Nice to meet you. She doesn't want to hook up with that guy. That guy's a different guy, and he doesn't realize it because what happens with consumption of drugs is it wears away at you over time. And these drugs, like marijuana, not only can it lead to more serious drugs, but marijuana can steal the magic that is you, that little edge, that little thin, sharp response that you have to things and that awareness. And it's another escape. Smoking marijuana, drinking alcohol to excess, all these things are, for me, they're saying, I don't want to be part of this present moment. This present moment that God gave me, isn't enough. I gotta quit this video because we're done with raspberries. Okay, buddy, bye. Okay. So tell them, buddy. Say, this present moment is enough. We don't need drugs, right? Say it. Right? Woo! Okay. Okay, we're gonna quit. Say bye. Turn it off, buddy. Yeah.